Dear viewers, welcome to our channel for online literature help. Please subscribe to this channel and you will be able to keep yourself updated with MA and BA English curriculum of various universities. आज हम जो नॉवल करने जा रहे हैं उसका नाम है द हिस्ट्री ऑफ टॉम जॉन्स अ फाउंडलिंग विच वॉज रिटन बाई हेनरी फील्डिंग. हेनरी फील्डिंग वॉज एन इंग्लिश नॉवलिस्ट एंड ड्रामेटिस्ट known for his rich earthy humor and satirical prowess. Prowess means skill or expertise in a particular activity or a field. And as the author of picaresque novel is a genre, a category that depicts the adventure of a low moral person, low moral social class, who lives by his wits in a corrupt society. This is the novel Tom Jones, which falls under the category of picaresque. Henry Fielding, the author of this novel, was born on April 22, 1707 at Chapman Park, Somerset, England, and died on October 8, 1754 in Lisbon. Novelist and playwright who, with Samuel Richardson, is considered a founder of the English novel, among his major novels are Joseph Andrews and Tom Jones, which was written in 1749. Before getting to know the novel, let me tell you about the title. Foundling. Foundling is an infant that has been abandoned by its parents and is discovered and cared for by others. The protagonist of our novel is a foundling. The story revolves around him. How? Let us see. The story of this novel is to explore human nature. As such, his story moves between several extremes, comedy and tragedy, low and high, morale and base. The story starts with a man whose name is Squire Alworthy. He is a man defined by his immense kindness, returns to his Somerset estate to find a child abandoned in his bed. He gives the child to his sister Bridget to look after, and they investigate to determine that the child's mother is a young woman named Jenny Jones. She leaves the area and Alworthy decides to raise the boy, Tom Jones. Tom is brought up alongside Alworthy's nephew, Blifil, Bridget's son. They are educated by two men of differing outlook, Thockum and Squire, their neighbors. Blifil is miserable and a jealous boy. Tom grows up to be an impulsive character who supports his friend, the poor gamekeeper. Impulsive means somebody who is acting or done quickly and without any thought or care. And gamekeeper is a person who is employed to take care of a large estate. So meanwhile, throughout his behavior, his relationship with Squire Weston, who is Alworthy's rough and rude but agreeable neighbor, Tom Jones slowly falls in love with Squire's daughter Sophia, who also reciprocates the love. However, Tom cannot pursue Sophia because he is already having a girlfriend, Molly, daughter to Black George. She grows pregnant with what he believes to be his son, and when he is revealed not to be the father of Molly's child, Tom is free again to pursue his growing love for Sophia. In the meanwhile, Blifil schemes against Tom, and Tom is unjustly turned out of Alworthy's house and away from Sophia. Unjustly is in a manner that is not in accordance with what is morally right and fair. Further, because Tom is an illegitimate child, Squire Weston also refuses to support Tom's suit for Sophia. He disapproves their love and instead wishes her to marry Blifil so that he can confiscate their lands. Sophia hates Blifil and is tortured by her father's cruel command. Alworthy gives Tom a fair amount of money to support himself, but it is stolen by Black George. Tom considers joining the army. He meets up with Petridge, a teacher cum barber whose reputation was ruined when he was believed to be Tom's father years before. Mr. Petridge is the unfortunate schoolmaster who is falsely accused by his wife as well of fathering the child called Tom Jones. Partridge initially believes that he can return to Allworthy's favor if he reunites the man with Tom, but Partridge ultimately becomes a devoted companion of Tom along the way. Tom frequently shows his kind spirit by helping an unsuccessful highwayman, a beggar, and a lady in distress, all gestures which are richly repaid later in the novel. Tom also rescues a lady, Mrs. Waters, from being robbed, and they begin an affair at a local inn. During all these happenings, an Irishman, Fitzpatrick, arrives at the inn searching for his wife. In the meanwhile, Sophia is locked up for refusing to marry Blifil. She flees, and both Tom and Sophia try to locate each other on their respective journeys to London. She reaches to the inn where Tom stays at present and discovers he has slept with Mrs. Waters, the woman he rescues, and overhears that he is mentioning her name to strangers as a lover, and she decides he must not love her, and she then heads to London and Tom follows her. While in London, Tom takes up with the immoral and shrewd Lady Ballaston. Lady Ballaston is a relative of Sophia, and Sophia runs to her house in London when she is first trying to escape her father and Mr. Blifil. So, with whom Sophia is also staying, she promises to help him but endeavors to keep the lovers apart. So, Mrs. Ballaston, although seems that she will help the lovers, but she tries her best to keep the lovers apart because she is seeing Tom. After seeing Tom, she herself has fallen in love with him. Lady Ballaston and Tom begin an affair, although Tom privately continues to pursue Sophia as well. Okay. When he and Sophia are reconciled, Tom breaks up the friendship with Lady Ballaston by sending her a marriage proposal that scares her away. Yet Lady Ballaston is still determined not to allow Sophia and Tom's love to flourish. She encourages another young man, Lord Fellamer. Lord Fellamer is a noble person who is a frequent visitor at Lady Ballaston's house. So she encourages Lord Fellamer to rape Sophia. Sophia is also roughly courted by Lord Fellamer. In the meanwhile, Sophia's aunt, Lady Weston, is anxious for her to marry him, whereas her father is still adamant that she will marry Blifil. Sophia decides she will marry no one without her father's consent, but she will also not be told whom to marry. Soon after, Squire Weston, Mrs. Weston, Blifil, and Allworthy arrive in London, and Squire Weston locks Sophia in her bedroom. Mr. Fitzpatrick thinks Tom is his wife's lover and begins a duel with him. In defending himself, Tom stabs Fitzpatrick with a sword and is thrown into jail. So Tom is innocently caught up in the duel and is imprisoned. His friend Nightingale, loyal companion Partridge, and devoted landlady Mrs. Miller. Mrs. Miller is the owner of the inn where Tom stayed. So all three of them investigate the course of Tom's imprisonment and sustain his contact with Sophia. There is a tension when it is initially believed that Mrs. Waters is Tom's mother. Mrs. Waters is considered to be the same person, Jenny Jones, who years back was considered to be the mother of Tom. But this is revealed to be untrue. Allworthy is shocked to discover that Tom is his nephew, Bridget's illegitimate but firstborn son, and that Blifil has known about this since his mother's death. It is discovered that Blifil planned Tom's imprisonment to get him out of the way. The charges against Tom are dropped, and his marriage to Sophia is blessed by both Allworthy and Squire Weston. Blifil is banished but has an annuity. Annuity is a fixed sum of money paid to someone each year. So he gets annuity from Allworthy and Tom. Sophia and Tom live happily close to Nightingale and Mrs. Miller's daughter Nancy, whose union also Tom facilitated. So Partridge is given an annuity to start a new school and marries Tom's first girl, Molly Seagrim. Fielding did not want to create a necessarily moral text that ignored the truth of how people are. He believed human nature has capacity for good and evil and wanted to explore those contradictions. Further, it is important to note that Fielding was not advocating or defending any of the immoral behaviors of his characters, but just merely presenting their actions as steps on the road to greater wisdom. Indeed, each of the major characters already mentioned undergoes a learning process, and redemption is offered to anyone who seeks it. Here we go. These are my contact details. Please subscribe to my channel for more tips and tricks about examination and any help on literature. Thank you for watching.